poem. There's beauty in the words, and but it's wrought with despair and darkness and loss. But Edgar Allan Poe has this way of taking his words and making it into this beautiful poem that has lasted the ages, and I wanted to capture that in the movement and in the music and the arc of the story. So the audiences can walk away relating in whatever way they want to, and there's always the risk of falling off at the edge. And we make that evident in the show too, in our aerial acts. There's always this heightened sense of we're all immortal, and we could, you know, quote unquote, like fall off the tight wire at any moment, or you're at a height, and that I think has an energy that can tell the poem very well.
Into the crypt they bring my earthly shell to take its rest. They'll bury me in spring. Brother Edwin, our last hope is sent to take the cure, but death is not yet done with us, of that much I am sure. Enough, enough, our father cries. Take up your axe and spade. A demon's hand is working here, not our godly fate. Our dead are full of vengeance, sunk in their boxes of pine. They rise in the dark to drink the blood of those they left behind. Men gather their torches and hatchets, tear us out of our thrones, check us for signs of living, for sweetness of flesh on our bones. Mother is tattered like age-old silk. Mary's dust rises to greet. But I, in my cool, icy waiting bed, still blush as if filled with life's heat. 'Tis her, they cry, the vampire fowl. And through my ribs they crash the axe and pull my dead heart out and burn it until ash. Drink, dear son, take a sip of mercy's cinder heart. But soon enough comes Edwin's end, comes his turn to depart. Deep in the blue mist of Exeter, we lie here under the stones, our names overgrown with soft green moss, marking the beds of our bones. Thank you.
It was then that he saw the shadows dance along the walls, and he felt the very room shrink, as the shadow grew in size and menace, until it was no longer a shadow at all, but a tall, hooded figure, death incarnate.